Hi everybody, today I wanted to share with you some of my favorite products and some tips for oily skin. Now, there are two cons or two drawbacks that comes with having oily skin. One is you are acne prone or you are likely to be acne prone. I'm raising two hands here. And then another thing is that your makeup doesn't tend to stay on as long because the oils on your skin break it down the way any oil-based makeup remover would. So, based on that, I'm gonna share with you some ways around those negative drawbacks and some tips and some products that I use to keep my oil under control and keep my skin looking nice or as nice as possible. With that, let me go ahead and jump into showing you some products. So the first thing I want to mention is a moisturizer. Now I know you're probably thinking that if you have oily skin, you don't need to moisturize your skin. And although that could be true, I guess theoretically, it's not true for me at all because I tend to use acne medication. I mean, acne medications, acne creams, I guess they are medications. But ultimately, what I want to say is that my skin can be dry even though it gets oily throughout the day. When I take my makeup off and stuff, I can notice that it's flaky. So I do moisturize my skin, but I use very light moisturizers. So the one that I use for my face specifically is the Cetaphil Moisturizing Lotion. Here is a quick preview. It used to have a blue cap, and actually you can probably see I have one right there and it has a blue cap on it. That's the older design. I think the new one has the green cap on it or something, but anyway, this moisturizer is great because it's lightweight, it's good for sensitive skin, it's fragrance free, and I have never felt like it was giving me any acne on top of my already existing acne or that it made my face feel greasy and oily. So this one is a really great product. I've been using it for years and I highly recommend it for anyone who feels like they've got or who has oily skin. So another product I wanted to mention is the Bioré Nose Strips. Here I have a little cute tin of them, and in this tin I've got a couple of these little guys in there, and as you can see in the instructions, if it would zoom in, what you do is you just take the nose strip out and then you apply it to your nose, you wet it, and then you wait a little while and then you peel it off. And what it does is it basically, what it's supposed to do is it's supposed to take some of the blackheads out. People who produce a lot more oil tend to have blackheads more than people who don't. So if you have oily skin, you probably notice that you have blackheads. And these pore strips are great. I mean, they are not gonna solve your, you know, blackheads problems right away, but they do make a big difference, and I use them on a daily basis, or I should say weekly basis. And ever since I've been using these strips, I have noticed a big difference in my blackheads, and so I highly recommend them. So next I want to mention a cleanser, the Clean and Clear Advantage 3-in-1 Exfoliating Cleanser, which looks like this. Hope you can see it. This is actually recommended to me by my boyfriend, and even though I was really skeptical to use this, I gave it a shot and I have to say that I love it. Not only did I notice that my acne was starting to, or is starting to, clear up, my skin is a lot less oily now that I've been using this. If you're looking for an inexpensive cleanser that's also a acne treatment in one, this is a great option. Next, I want to mention a product that's always with me in my bag wherever I go, and the product is blotting papers. Now, I got the cheapest ones of Amazon, but there are different brands out there, and I don't have a specific brand that I wanted to recommend. Instead, I want to recommend blotting papers in general. So blotting papers are actually little thin pieces of, I want to say parchment paper, but I'm not gonna say because I'm not sure, but they're thin pieces of paper that you use to take some of the oil off your skin. So let me just give you a quick little preview here. I don't know how much oil I have because I kind of took it off recently, but hopefully I have enough to show you. It's gonna be a little gross, so don't judge me, but here. So if you can see that little dark spot in the center of the paper, that's oil. And I use these throughout the day when I feel like my face is getting a little bit too shiny. So these blotting papers are a must-have for anybody who has oily skin. And last product I want to mention is actually not just one product, it's a product duo, and that is the Makeup Forever foundation and concealer. Let me give you a quick preview here. So I've been using them for a while. I've used this for a little bit less than I have used this. I found this in college, the concealer, and absolutely loved it. It's like the best concealer for oily skin or for people who have acne. Here is a quick preview, and my shade is number 6. So this makeup combination not only stays on all day, so I apply my makeup in the morning and it lasts throughout the day, but it also doesn't cause more acne for me, so it doesn't block pores, and it does a really great job of covering acne as well. So I absolutely love this combination, and if you were gonna give only one of them a try, definitely go for the concealer because it's amazing, although I do like the foundation as well. They are a little pricey, so the concealer I believe is $30 and this is $45, but I have to say that they are worth it because they last for a long time. You know, they do a great job of doing what they're supposed to do, which is conceal, cover, and last. So that's it for all the products that I use for my crazy oily skin. But before I go, I wanted to give you a quick tip if you are suffering from acne. The tip is to wash your makeup brushes, wash your pillowcases, and anything that basically touches your skin. And actually, don't touch your skin if at all possible with your hands, or if you do touch your skin with your hands, make sure you wash them beforehand. If you're not washing your makeup brushes or your pillowcase and it touches your skin, it transfers the bacteria and it causes acne. And I noticed that once I wash my makeup brushes on a regular basis, I get much less acne and pimples than if I weren't to wash my brushes as regularly. And I actually did a quick video on how to wash makeup brushes using baby shampoo. That's the technique that I use, or that's the product that I use. And if you're interested in watching that, I'm gonna link that down below. And with that, I want to say thank you for watching. If you have any questions or comments, leave them down below and I'll be happy to answer them. And again, thanks for watching and have a great day. Bye.